Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss antiderivatives. Let's do an example. The question says to find the most general antiderivative of f. In part A, we have the function f of x equals x squared plus 3x plus 2. Let's work through it. Solution. So the process of finding an antiderivative is called antidifferentiation. So basically, it's the opposite of differentiation. There's a couple rules we can use. So I'm going to call our antiderivative big F of x. This is going to be our antiderivative. And so whenever you have x to a power, you basically just add 1 to the exponent and divide by the result. So 2 plus 1 is 3. And then you divide by that number. There's also x to a power here. And so here, you just add 1 and divide. So it'll be plus 3 x squared over 2. This trick will always work as long as your power is not negative 1. If your power is negative 1, then it's a different formula. So again, we added 1 to the 2, we got x cubed and divided, added 1 to the 1, got 2 and divided. Whenever you have a constant, you just attach an x to it, 2x. And we always have to add a plus c at the end of our answer. And this is called an antiderivative of little f. Because if you take the derivative of this, you're just going to get back little f. And so this is the answer. You could check your answer. Let's do it really quickly. Big F prime of x. Using the power rule for differentiation, we get 3x squared over 3. The constant hangs out because it's a constant. Plus 2 times 3 is 6, so we get 6x over 2. The derivative of 2x is 2 because the derivative of x is 1. And the derivative of c is 0. This is equal to, boom, these cancel, x squared plus 6 over 2 is 3, 3x, and then we still have a 2 here, so it checks. Oh, look at that. That's equal to little f. So big F prime of x is equal to f of x. And this is true for all x. That's what it means for big F to be an antiderivative of little f. And again, this process is called antidifferentiation. Let's do another one. Part B. We have f of x equals 2 times e to the x plus the sine of x. Let's work through this one. Solution. So big F of x is going to be our antiderivative. The 2 is a constant, so it hangs out. And then we antidifferentiate e to the x, which is just e to the x. Antidifferentiate sine, you have to think backwards. Think, okay, what's a function whose derivative is sine? Well, the derivative of cosine is negative sine. So here we need a negative cosine. And you can check. You take the derivative of negative cosine, you're going to get negative negative sine, which is just sine. And don't forget the plus c at the very end. So that would be the antiderivative. Let's go ahead and do a problem that is a little more challenging. Let f double prime of x be equal to 2 cosine x plus 3 sine x, f of 0 be equal to 1, f prime of 0 be equal to 2, and we're going to find f of x. Let's work through this problem. Solution. So to do this problem, we're going to do it in steps. So step one is we're going to antidifferentiate the second derivative. When we do that, we get the first derivative, so f prime of x. And now again, we're antidifferentiating, so we have to think backwards. What's a function whose derivative is cosine? Well, that's going to be sine. 2 sine x. Now we have to antidifferentiate sine x. What's a function whose derivative is sine? Well, it's going to be negative cosine. So this is negative 3 cosine x. You should always check. The derivative here is going to be 2 cosine x, checks. And then the derivative of cosine is negative sine, but we already have a negative, so it's positive, so it checks. Then we add the plus c. So step one, you antidifferentiate to get f prime. Now you use your condition here to find c. So f prime of 0 is equal to 2 times the sine of 0 minus 3 times the cosine of 0 plus c. And that's equal to 2. So plug in 0, set it equal to 2. Sine of 0 is 0, so we just get 0 minus 3 times 1, because cosine of 0 is 1, plus c equals 2. Minus 3 plus c equals 2. C is equal to 5. Then you take the C and you plug it back into your F prime. F prime of X is equal to 2 sine x minus 3 cosine x plus 5. Let's go over that again. First step is you antidifferentiate once. That gives you f prime. Don't forget the plus c. Second step is you use your condition to find c. So you plug in 0 for your x's, and then you solve for c. Then you take that, and you plug it back in, and you have it here. Then you repeat the process, except this time, when you antidifferentiate, you're going to get f, which is the answer. So we get f of x. And again, what's a function whose derivative is sine? Well, negative cosine. So we have negative 2 cosine x minus antidifferentiating cosine is just going to give us sine, so minus 3 sine x. Antidifferentiating 5 gives us 5x. Then we have our plus c. You antidifferentiate, and then you use your other condition, f of 0 equals 1, to find c. F of 0 is equal to negative 2 times cosine 0 minus 3 times sine 0 plus 5 times 0 plus c. And it's equal to 1 this time, right? Because you set it equal to 1. So we have cosine 0 is 1, so we get negative 2, sine 0 is 0, and then plus 0 plus c equals 1. You add 2, so you get c equals 3. Take it, plug it back in. So we end up with f of x equals negative 2 cosine x minus 3 sine x plus 5x plus 3. Boom, there's the answer. So it's really not hard if you just follow the steps. Let me just go over it again really quickly from the beginning, and I'll use a different color to explain. I'll use red. You see the problem, and you're told that the second derivative is equal to this. By the way, this is called a differential equation because it involves an unknown function f and one or more of its derivatives. And these conditions here are actually called initial conditions. And if you look at this entire problem, just extra life knowledge, it's called an initial value problem. So just extra knowledge that, just extra good knowledge for math. Anyways, first step in this problem. So step one is you antidifferentiate. You get f prime right here. So we just antidifferentiate, we get this. Second step, use the condition to find c. Take your c, plug it back in, and we're here. Okay, we're here at this point. So you antidifferentiate, use your condition, find c, plug it in. Then you repeat the process. Antidifferentiate again. Don't forget to put the plus c. And then you use your condition again. F of 0 equals 1. Use that to find c. So you just plug in 0, set it equal to 1, find c, plug it back in. Then you write your answer down, and you're done. Hopefully you've learned some math in this video. This problem is really cool. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck.